Like every Christmas story, this one's about new life in the dead of winter. But I didn't know that at the time. I was just a college kid coming home for vacation with my brother Pat. It was 1977. My hometown of Placerville is up in the foothills of the High Sierra. It's not that far from Berkeley as the crow flies. It was just another world away for me. Christmas in Placerville never changed. Every year I painted the scenery for the church pageant. And every year Mom took the children's choir up to the mountains to listen to the wind in the trees.
Oh, what are you doing here? Oh, my beautiful boys. Home is where I'm
neighbor, Mr. Rosa, knew every shred of gossip in town.
Jupiter, he's missing his hunt. That's German, you know.
Jupiter, stop kissing Tom.
Hi, Mr. Rosa.
Thanks.
Tom.
There, Pat.
How are you?
They all get that thing running yet, Marianne?
I'll go look at it.
You should know that big Thanksgiving rain. My house weathered fine. I keep it in mint condition. It's all in the upkeep. But your mom, oh, the roof leaked something terrible. Then the water pipe froze, it burst, and...
Water damage, huh? She didn't tell us.
Marianne wouldn't have told you. You know how your mother is.
Yeah. You know what? Thanks for sharing, Mr. Rosa.
You know, with you boys off at school, and you know, she's all alone, but she still teaches the kids how to sing, and she sews all the Christmas pageant costumes, and, oh, she's got... Pep, your mom.
Yeah, mucho pep.
You boys should get on the stick for her. She doesn't spill her own beans.
So you spill them for me. Well, it needs oil for one thing. You know, Mr. Rosa, if you ever did get the truck fixed, you wouldn't have anything to gossip about, would you? Come on, guys. I've got to get supper over to Glenn.
Thanks, right. Mr. Rosa.
See you, Mr. Rosa.
Sometimes life moves in mysterious ways, and sometimes... there's no mystery at all. Like when Glenn Westman built a studio across the field from us. Having a famous artist next door was like God's finger pointing me toward painting. All through high school, Glenn taught me what it means to be an artist.
Glenn, close the damn door.
Glenn, it's Tom.
It's cold in here. Why would you leave the door open?
Where on earth are you?
In the corner, like little Jack Horner.
What?
Come in. I'm learning Latin, a dead language for the dead. Maleficent crap, eh?
They're not done.
Some things are better left undone. I can't capture her, can't paint the loss. My hands won't cooperate. Don't get old. That's the sum of my wisdom at this advanced age. Don't get old. Don't get a damned hand. Nothing works the way it used to.
Let me get that.
Right.
Yep.
Don't get old. Pin it up. How's your work? I'd like to see what you've been painting.
I feel lost, really. Here. Because I've been doing a lot of expressionistic stuff lately.
That will get you lost very quickly. Don't reduce art to something that's about the artist. Art isn't about the artist, it's about life. Life. Beauty. Love. Emotion. Art should bring emotion that can topple tyranny.
I haven't forgotten, Glenn.